Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. Today, I want to show you how to perform a mail merge from data that you collect in Microsoft Excel to a letter in Microsoft Word, where you can merge them together with that information. This is going to save you a tremendous amount of time. When you're done, hit print and get them all printed at once, or hit email and it will send it through Outlook to all the people. These are the practice files that I'm going to be using here today to perform my mail merge. I have a Microsoft Excel workbook with just a little bit of information with 10 entries, and I have this Microsoft Word letter that I already wrote. And if you want to follow along with this tutorial here today, just look down below in the description and you can download these exact same files. So a mail merge, what I want to have happen here is, if I look at this Microsoft Excel document, let's say you've collected information. In this case, I have 10 different names that I've collected with their addresses and emails here. And I have a letter that I went through and wrote. Now I want to be able to either print this letter out to give it to somebody, or I want to just automatically send it out in an email. But I don't want to go through each time and having to put Alex Smith over here and then the address, copying it over that way. Mail merge automatically happens in Microsoft Word, where it can pull from an Excel file, and where I choose to set up the different places, it can pull the information quickly from here and replace it, and you don't really have to do that much. And then you can hit print on everything, so it'll just print out all the different pages you need, or you can send it directly to your Outlook that will email out. So these are the things that I want to show you how to do today. I just want to point out, if you're creating your own Excel spreadsheet, make sure in that first row across the top that you go and put some headers across. It just makes it easier when you're pulling that into Microsoft Word. Other things you can think about is, do you need first name, last name separated, or do you want them their own column? How do you want the addresses? But this is going to be based on your own preference. I'm going to go close out of this now, and I'm back into Microsoft Word into our letter. What should we want to have? This information right through here replaced. So to do this, if we look up to the tabs, all we need to go is to mailings over here. I want to point out that I'm using Microsoft 365, so I have the most updated Word and Excel, but this has been very similar for a long time with whatever version of Microsoft Word that you've been using. Now, the first step what we want to be able to do is connect to that Excel list that we have. And that's going to be right through here. So if we look in the ribbon where it says Start Mail Merge, I'm going to just click at this point and I get some options. So you could start it from scratch right from here. You could go type a new list. So I could go through, enter names and go through and enter that information in, but that would take some time and I want to be as quick as possible, especially if I already have that in an Excel workbook like I do. And we can also go from our Outlook contacts. So if you had a bunch in your Outlook contacts, they could go and grab that information and pull it. So that might be a good option if you have that information in Outlook. But we're going to go and use an existing list. This is where I need to go find where I have it. So I have a folder just on my desktop and I have it it's going to be in Mail Merge. And this is where I keep my letter, but I also have the Excel document right here. So I'm going to go ahead and open this now. And this is the sheet. It's only the one sheet on it and I didn't name it anything special. But take a look at this. I have this checked. The first row of data contains column headers. So make sure with this one you have that selected. So now I'm just going to go ahead and hit OK. So notice now, ever since I clicked that and brought those in, I have more options on my ribbon. And let's take a look at this right here. So I can now edit the recipient list. So if I go ahead and click on this, I'm going to just expand this a bit so you can see it more. Look at the options that we have in here. And I know I only have 10 lists, so it's not very large. But if I wanted to take people off the list to send to or print a document to, I can just uncheck them like this. You can also break it down by sorting. So there's arrows right up here where you can go sort ascending or descending. But what I like is you could also filter. So the filter allows you to add different fields that you wanted to filter by. Let's say if you wanted to look at a specific state, you could go and find that state. And if there's multiple people for there, then it would only be either being printing for that or sending the email to those ones. So you can break it down and find, create the ones that exactly what you need it for. You can go find the recipient, or you can even validate the the addresses down here. But take advantage of making sure you get the right people that you know that you're working with. I'm just going to hit OK here. Let's start right up here in the address, the name and the address line. Now, when I wrote this in Microsoft Word, I didn't actually need to have any of this. I could delete it right now if I wanted to. And I'll do this a few different ways to show you that how you can work with inserting different fields. Now, a quick way you could do it is if you did write it out like I did, you could go through spot by spot and go up to insert merge. And these are all the fields from that Excel document. So those are the headers that I created. So if I click on first name, now I've just replaced that with the actual spot that will get replaced with the document. So I can go last name. So I could go through each of these and highlight them, and I know it's going to get replaced as I do that. So that's one way you could do this. So you could do this anywhere in the document. So let's say in an Excel spreadsheet, it had their last purchase in there. Then you could be starting your letter. Well, I've noticed you bought this, and you could have last purchase, and it would be different for whatever that person bought. Now, a different way we could do this, and this will be a little quicker, is I'm going to just delete this here. And let's say we never even put that first that in, we can just go to the address block. So if I click the address block, now it shows me a preview, and this is what I like here. It shows me kind of what the preview will look like. This is probably the one we want, first name, last name on it. But if I click on different ones, you can see how it would change based on different things. So, but I want the first name, last name like that. Now, I do want to point out, you can over on the side, you can kind of scroll through and see the preview of each of the 10 entries that I do have. So you could go through and take a look what they look like. If you ever have different problems, this is working out for me, but if you, let's say maybe something was missing, a street address or something, sometimes there's mistakes, you can go to correct problems here and through match fields, where you might have to go through and pick where it's not, maybe it didn't match correctly through the Excel document, and then I could drop down and match it here. So just to say, if something didn't come out, you can do that. So, but this is working for me. I'm gonna go and just hit okay now, and we have this address block. So this is a very quick way to do the address. Let's move down to the greeting line right here. Now we can do the same thing that I showed you before. I could highlight, I could delete this all if I want, go up, put first name, and this would work. It would just change for whatever person. When I go and print it out or email it out, it would adapt, it would match the address block as well. But I prefer actually to go to the greeting line here, and I'm going to show you why. So if I just delete all that line and I'm going to put it back here, I'll click on greeting line. We have a few different options. So we have greeting line format. We could say to or dear. I'll leave it at dear. How formal do you want it to be? Take a look at what the preview for each of these would be here as well. I want to keep this a little less formal, so this is just going to be Dear Alex. I can go through and take a look what it looks like for everybody down below. Do we want a comma, or how do we want this separated afterwards? So for punctuation, I'll just leave it there. This is what I like. In case from the list a name was missing or didn't have it, we can, for an invalid response, we can still make sure it says something. So if I drop down, maybe I want it just to be to whom it may concern, or maybe I want it as none, but you have that option there. Remember, if there's any issues, just like before, to go and check any match fields to go and see if there is something missing from the data. But this looks good here. I'm just going to hit OK. So now I have my address block that is going to pull out for each letter. It's going to have a greeting line that will match to the right person. Let's do one more thing. Let's say at the very bottom, I have this. We have this email and file, and we'll add, is this correct? So I want to be able to pull out each person's email. So maybe I want it right here. I can go up at this time, just insert that field, and it's going to be email. And we'll leave it like that. So I think we got all the different places that we want the information pulled from that Excel document into this Word document. An important thing to do after you've inserted your different fields and greeting lines and addresses is to go to the preview up here. So take a look. Right now it's not on the preview, but look at address block. As soon as I click this on, it shows me what this would look like. And if I arrow through to the different recipients, You can check to see if what which ones, how they look, and you can make any changes. So if you had extra spaces in any of these, if you saw duplicate names, you can edit right in the preview results and it will make that change. The other thing that you can do is actually check for errors here. So you can take a look at the different options. You can simulate the mail merge. I have a pretty simple one with only 10 different ones, but this is just another option that you can do just to check for any possible errors here. So when you're all done, if you want, you can turn off your preview if you want, but if everything's looking good, I always like to make a save of this as I'm going along. So you can just save this document once you have your different information, all the different fields in. But if I go over to finish and merge, I have some different options. And I want to talk about these ones right here, the print documents and send email messages. Now, if I go to print document, even though there's just the one page here, if I go and hit all and hit OK and select my printer, it's going to print out the 10 different ones that I have. So it's going to go through and print out the name on each of these separately with the different places. So if I just hit OK, I'd go and go to the printer that I want, and then it would be done. So this is a great way to print those. If you are mailing these, take a look at the envelopes up top, because you can actually do a mail merge with this that would match to be placing it on there. The other thing that you can do, and probably how I would be doing a lot of this, is just emailing out things, these documents. So if we go to send email messages, notice right away it picked the correct field. It chose email out of all the different ones that I had through the Excel document. At this point, I'm going to leave it as the email, and I'm going to put a subject line. We'll just say, is your email correct in here? What type of mail format do we want it to be? Do we want it to be attachment, plain text, HTML? And the next one is, do we want all of them? So we only have 10. I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. Then you'll see it zip through all the different ones. And then I'm going to open up Microsoft Outlook to show you. But just to let you know, these are fake email addresses, so I am going to get them returned. As it zips through, you see it all changing of what's getting sent out. Let's go over to Outlook now. In Outlook, it's all coming through as undeliverable, as I thought, because these are the fake emails. But if they were real emails, they would have been sent out. So just, and you can see if I go to sent items, there they were right there showing that it was being sent out. But then if I take a look at the message, here was the message right here. It was sent as HTML as a form letter inside of this. So you can see how this will save you so much time if you're taking information from that Excel sheet that you've created, and then just with a simple document and mail merging them, you can have it either printed or emailed out so quickly. So I hope you like this tutorial on how to mail merge from Microsoft Excel to Word to Outlook. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.